So in this session, we are going to look at how we can set up the environment. So first you can search Anaconda download, and once you search that, it will navigate to this URL. And here you can see you can get the individual edition, right? And here you get the download option. So here is fully open source and we have the packages. So right now it support over 7500 packages. Also we can add third party packages as well. And there's option to manage the environment as well. So as I showed you earlier, we have the support for these packages by default, and also we can do machine learning, deep learning also using this package. And this is the user interface it looks like. So it comes with these tools. So we have this GUI packages where we can use to develop both Python and R. So in this course, we target mostly toward Python language and how we can use the machine learning package. So you can click the download here, right? And you can select the distribution. I recommend to download 64-bit version because it's much more faster. So here you have option to download for either Linux, Mac or Windows. Also I recommend to download the latest version because latest version gives you latest features and also up-to-date things when it comes to machine learning and data science. So if you are Windows user, you can download this, which is 64-bit installer. If you are Mac user, you can download this, or if you are Linux user, you can download this. So once you download this, it will go through the installation and it will install the packages. So once you install, you will come to this kind of environment, right? And also here we have these packages, that means these GUI tools are installed. So one of the main tool we are going to use the Jupyter Notebook, and other main tool is the Spider software, right? So first thing is you can click the, once you install everything, you can click the launch button. Then it will launch this kind of a environment, which is you can create a Spider software, right? So this is a Spider software, right? So here what you can do is you can create a new environment, right? And you can create a new file. So here I have some sample projects here, right? So once you create a new file, you get the empty environment and project, right? So always you need to remember what kind of project environment you are going to work on, right? Based on that, what you can do is you can select the environment and then you can work on that. So here I create an empty one. So you can easily create file new and you can get this kind of empty one like earlier, right? So once you get the empty one, what you can do is you can start implementing some code, right? So once you get the empty one, it looks like this, right? Then here you have this console environment, right? Where we get the output window, and we have the variable explorer, file explorer, and a help, right? So in the next session, I will highlight more things in here, right? So at the same time, I will launch the Jupyter Notebook as well, in order to demonstrate that software. So these are the two softwares that we can use in this environment, right? Where we can use to develop our data science packages, right? And there are goods and bads while using these two packages, right? So I will highlight these things throughout the course. But at this step, your main goal is to install the Anaconda environment correctly, and also check, make sure whether you have a working Spider and a Jupyter Notebook, right? So here you can see we have a workspace environment. We can create a .py, which is a Python file, right? Which is a Python file that we can use to create this environment. So we need to first make sure whether these things works. Once these things works, we can start working in our application in the data science tools, right? So that is the first thing you need to show. So I will just load a sample one and demonstrate some of the ways that we can do some coding, right? So these are some sample codes that I used in previous projects, right? So here you can see we have things like for machine learning, we can use for TensorFlow, right? So several purposes we can use, right? So the one thing what we can do is I will just so we are doing these things later, but here I want to show you that we can use this and we can run this application correctly, right? So I will just use run, right? So you can see what are the things that is happened, right? So that the moment you don't need to go through code, because later I will discuss all this code step by step. But right now I just want to highlight the software spider and what we have did, right? So normally if you want to get output, we need to use the print command, and here we are going to print out and see what are the data. So when you, we can execute this command like this, and here you can see the output in the console. So additionally, this software give another benefits, which is called a variable explorer. So you can double click this and see what are the content in this data structure visually. So that is another benefits compared to the next software I'm going to highlight, which is the Jupyter Notebook, right? So let's look at Jupyter Notebook environment, which is this one. So here what we can do is we can create a new file, right? So we have this option to create a new file. So here I will create a Python file, right? So the Python file you can create like this. So here I can name this file, right? Let's say create something like hello, right? So I create something like this Python file, right? So you can see Jupyter Notebook running in the cloud or the browser. So we have a URL here, localhost/notebook/hello.ipynb. So ipynb is literally a Python file wrapped around a Jupyter Notebook, and here the execution is a bit different, and there's a good and bad when you compare in the code. So one thing is you can use this cell environment to write the code, and you can use this plus button to create multiple cells, right? And you can execute cell by cell, but in the previous software in the spider, you need to execute everything at once. You don't get the option to select as cells. So let me copy the previous code here, right? So here I can set something like this, right? So let me run this, right? So you can see the similar output. And also if I do this, right, and if I put S here, then you can see it's the same output. So you don't need to type print here, you get the same output like earlier. And also you can separate these by tab special these cells as well. So for example, you can do something like that. So it's really good for code separation, right? So here the importing part and here the coding part, right? So likewise, you can do the separation here. And also we have option to run cell, run all. Likewise, we have option to run these things, right? So this is called a Jupyter Notebook file, and this is give the same output, but here we have option to do the separation, right? So for example, we can execute this this cell individually from this cell, but here we don't have that option. So you can see here we don't get that option to select either this part and this part. So if you run this button, everything runs together, but here you get the option to select only to this to execute or this to execute. So based on several requirement, you get the goods and bads of this. When it comes to visualization, and if you have a large code base that we want to isolate, this is a really good option that you can go through, right? And also we have option to download this as a Python file, even PDF file as well. So PDF is not supported in the local, but if you are running this in the cloud version, we get the PDF as well. But you can easily download a Python file and HTML file as well. Which is can be open again here in the spider. So this supports only Python py but not ipynb, right? But this is literally a Python file wrapped around this format, right? So in this section, the main goal is to set up the environment, right? So everything that we can do is, first thing is you need to download the software properly. It is completely free software. You can download it, install it, and once you install it, you can launch spider or a notebook and see whether this code works, right? So no need to go in depth in this code. I will explain this code in next section, which is our NumPy version. We are going to discuss more in depth each line by line these code sections, but here I just want to highlight about these two softwares. In the data science field, the Jupyter Notebook and the spider is the most used softwares. When it comes to spider, you can see this variable explorer. So this is a unique feature. So if you have a complex data type, you can just double click here, right? Double click here, and then you can get the details like this. So you don't get that here in the Jupyter notebook unless you type in the code, right? So for to get this, we didn't type anything. It's just part of this tool. So sometimes you can use these both tools side by side just to make sure that you get both benefits in all the tools.